could you tell us something about your first arrival in England and how you got into becoming an artist?
Yeah, I came to London, England in the late 60s, early 70s to study drama at the Royal Academy, which I did for a while. And then I was lucky enough to get some plays and acting. And then after this terrible accident I had skiing, convalescing, I thought, well, I have something to do. And someone gave me some oils, paint. And then I started just messing around. And then the next thing I know, people liked my work. And then I went home to Jamaica and started to paint seriously with the landscape of Jamaica, which is something I grew up with. And so that's one of the style that I do.
Could you please tell us something about the content and the style of your work?
Yeah, colour is something that I'm really interested in. I mean, I use very, very vibrant colours. But then coming from where I'm from in Jamaica, colours is something you see all the time. So yes, I do enjoy using colours that other people wouldn't put together. I mean, when I first started, it was like a joke, and now it's really serious. I mean, you know, it's that, and I can see from when I started to now the improvement in the work. Yeah, much, much more serious than when I first started, yeah. The style is, some people said intuitive, some said something else. As far as I'm concerned, I paint, and you know, I work in different techniques, in oils, watercolor, gouache, acrylic. Yeah, so I don't see myself as any special style, but the people now sort of recognize my work, and that's good enough for me, really, yeah.
Could you really could tell us something about the people that owns your painting?
Yes, I've been very lucky in selling my paintings to some very famous people, really, who sort of helped me also to sell some more because they had the work. Late Freddie Mercury, I sold quite a few paintings to. John Reed, Wesley Kerr, Ainsley Harriet, and to name quite a few, that's, you know, they have my work and I'm very lucky. People in the States, George Faison, Ashford and Simpson, Maya Angelou, they all have pieces of mine which I'm very lucky to part with.
So really, I understand that you're also quite a keen pottery maker.
Yes, it's something I was always interested in, so I went to the Warrington College to learn more about it. And this one is a technique of coiling with the glaze, the blue glaze and white stain. And yes, I think it's one of my nice pieces, really. So I'm hanging on to it. That's it. I'm terrible.
Could you please tell us something about this present exhibition you're holding?
Right. This present exhibition will be in Brixton in this amazing pub that does jazz and serve good food. Belong to a West Indian lady. Friends of mine asked me to, if I would put some paintings in there during the Black History Month. So I thought, well, why not? So I did some work, and the exhibition, which is in end of October, and I'm really looking forward to it. Hope I sell a few.
interest in African art anyway. And I'm loving the colours, I'm loving the vibrancy of the work. I guess nostalgic in a way. There's a sort of... there's a past that's kind of associated to the work, I guess. And there's sort of a reminiscence for a different place. Given that we are in London and given that we are in the middle of Tube Central, it's quite nice to be removed from that. I love that you can associate art with a context. I love that you can look at art and you can kind of pick it apart according to where it came from and what sort of society the person who made it has come from and what their personal influences are. And when I see art that is from a place that I've always wanted to go to, from a person who's experienced it and who's looking at it like that, it just makes me feel happy, I guess. It just makes me want to go there even more. And it makes me kind of want to see the things that he's talking about, I suppose. I've never been to Jamaica, and it's one of the places I've always wanted to go. So it's nice to see a perception of it instead of seeing it on a video. It's nice to see a sort of artistic interpretation of a country that is so obviously affectionate and is so obviously loving of a place.
Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arrive. Blackbird singing in the dead of the night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see.
I met Rudy in 1975, because we were all hanging out with Freddie Mercury at the time. I met him with Peter Straker, the artist. He's a fellow Jamaican. And Bibi, yeah. Trevor, who was running Monkbury's nightclub in Jermyn Street at the time. So we were all the whole gang together. He was sort of still doing his modelling, or just finished his one because of a massive accident on his back after a water skiing accident. He was still doing some shows. He did Boys in the Band and things like that. And then he did. He suddenly started his art after the accident. He got very interested in art in the hospital. And he did some commissions for Freddie Mercury and stuff like that. And I suppose just after that time, I started buying up his art. And I have 40 pieces now, along with some of his pottery works that he started in latter years. I've certainly collected all of that, hung on to it. I often bought things to give to people I thought it would be nice to give away.
Hung on to it.
I'm not going to give that to somebody who doesn't appreciate it. So I suppose that's how we've known each other all these years. We still keep in touch regularly.
Same as Gordon, really. I've always known Rudy. He's always been involved, heavily involved in his art. Always loved what he's done. Never actually bought a lot of pieces. Never really couldn't afford it, to be honest.
Being a struggling artist.
And the same, I met Rudy at the same time as Gordon, really. Through Peter Straker.
We all did, yeah.
We were all working together. And we were all tagged to Freddie Mercury through his Goose Productions, and Rudy was always around, all the parties.
Yep, so all the lunches, the parties, the trips.
Yes.
Fun days. So,
absolutely fantastic.
We miss you, Freddie. I'm sure he's here, it's clear. Oh, he's really listening.
Colin.
Wanted to be here. Yeah, of course. I first became acquainted with Rudy's work in Jamaica at an exhibition that Pat Ramsey had at the Mutual Life Gallery. And like you, I couldn't afford his work, but I was in love with the colour and the movement and just the simplicity of it. And I never thought I'd actually get to meet Rudy. I came to London and a friend of mine said, let's go and visit a friend of mine who's an artist who's not too well. We go and visit him. And there I went and met Rudy and saw his flat full of all his work. Not just paintings that I've become used to knowing, but also the pottery and all the bits and pieces that he's done. And his music, his vast music collection. He has an absolutely amazing collection of music and an appreciation.
But very, very taste.
I do enjoy his work and I find it very comforting. I started with a print and I now own 3 pieces, one reasonably sized one and 2 little ones. And I really enjoy them.
Actually, I don't. I've just been introduced today, so I really like his art. I think it's very interesting and very lively for a grey London. You wake up in the morning, you would want his picture to look at the bright colors that you never see in this city, definitely. I got introduced from Gordon, he just told me to come along. So. But I saw him in his flat in Ibiza because I live in Spain. So I did see lots of his work in his flat in Ibiza, but I didn't know him. I think he got like lots of life in there, lots of color to life.
Like Gordon and Mike, have known Rudy since the 70s, and I always have loved his art. And today, I have managed to buy my first piece.
Well done!
So wow. I'm really pleased.
Bravo! I love you, Gordon.
Very proud.
You'll never tire of it.
Describe the piece that you bought.
It's beautiful. It's called Sailing, and it's watercolour, and the watercolours bleed from the centre, so it can be sailing boats, it can be anything you like.
It's almost like a sunset picture or something, where the sky blends in with the sea.
It's beautiful.
It's really beautiful. I had my eye on that. We like that one. The sailing one, and they sort of want to blend in.
Hi, darling. Hope you don't go on.
She's Wendy's grandmother.
Lots of sun home.
I show bath and wash the soap. I don't know really what to know. I know his art's lovely. I've known him since the 70s. When he was introduced to me by Peter Straker and he was modelling in the National Theatre shows with all these people like Norman Beaton. And I'm not going to tell you the rest of the filthy bits. I'm keeping that for my book. My friend wants me to write a book, but I have got everything. I know where the bodies are buried. Just let him know that I know.
Hi, Rudy. Better give me a painting to keep me shut up. I love you.
It's a lovely day today.